Good afternoon, respected judges and my dear delegates. I will be presenting the result of our study on coming out with a simple technique of DMEC donor preparation, that is Sinsky-assisted Desmet endothelium frill formation and edge lifting for DMEC, which is simple and doesn't require any sophisticated or expensive equipment. We all know that DMEC is the most preferred endothelial keratoplasty technique currently, largely because of its best visual outcome and low risk of graft rejection. The other possible advantage, which I believe probably most important from our perspective, is its cost effectiveness. It doesn't require any microkeratom or any sophisticated equipment unlike DSEC. However, when you search for DMEC in India in literature, you could find only 11 reports are there, and bearing one last study by Basak et al. That included 100 eyes, most of them are simple case series or letter to editor. So what are the causes for this lagging behind the Western world? So, well, there could be multiple factors playing into this, like difficult graft preparation, requirement of sophisticated instrument, increased surgical manipulation and early graft complications, and a steep learning curve that lead to a wastage of good quality donor tissue. Our technique will at least address these two difficulties. So this brings to the purpose of my study, that is to come out with a simple technique of donor preparation for DMEC. So we procured 40 donor corneas from iBank, all of their optical grade tissue. For initial 25 eyes, what we did was all permutation combination of all available DMEC donor preparation techniques in literature. Whatever knowledge that we got from that, we used that for standardization of the in rest 15 eyes. So out of the lot of observations were made during this 25 eyes, but few of the most important were the adhesion between Desmet membrane and stroma is maximum in the periphery. So if you do a partial trephination of 9 to 9.5 mm size and separate this peripheral dense adhesion Desmet membrane from central relatively less adhesion Desmet membrane, then the chances of success is high. The second important was there is multiple focal adhesion points between the edges of Desmet membrane and the stroma at the trephination point. So if you can separate the peripheral 1 to 2 mm of Desmet membrane from the underlying stroma by breaking this focal adhesion using a blunt instrument like Sinsky hook, in fact this is what we did, then the chances of getting a DM tear is less. Thus, creating a 360 degree frill, peripheral frill is the clue to success of our technique. And one important step for this is partial trephination. If you do a full thickness trephination, then peeling becomes almost impossible. So one important sign as pointed out by one of my SR is this ring sign. If you could appreciate this ring of reflex within the inner margin of the manual trephine, if it is broad enough, then that means you are too deep. If it is relatively sharp, then that means you are quite superficial. Thus, creating the frill, you have to remember a few other points. Always apply the pressure of this Sinsky at the DM and stroma junction at around 30 to 45 degree. Never apply pressure directly over the Desmet membrane. So this is the video of one of our cases. So after partial trephination, you'll have to create a 360. This is the ring sign I was talking about. And using Sinsky hook, you can free the Desmet 360 degree all around. And one important point to remember is go slow and steady. If you apply too much force, then Newton's third law will come into play and there will be same amount of traction at the stroma DM junction, the chances of tear will be high. You can advance this frill little bit more at the point where you are going to peel, then the surgery becomes a little bit more easy. That insertion technique, you can do whatever technique you are comfortable with. I usually use a Alcon D cartridge for insertion of the graft, which is quite useful. So we defined our result as complete success when we could achieve an 8 mm roll without any peripheral tear, and partial when there was some peripheral tear not extending beyond 1 mm. This is the details of the donor. In summary, the median age of the donor was around 45 years. The death enucleation time was 6 hours. And 10 tissues were in MK media while 5 were in cornicel. The success rate was 87%, but here I would like to point out this number 15 donor, which was just 15 days old, which is nearly impossible to peel. So if we exclude this, then the success rate is almost 93%. So we compared that with two similar techniques described in literature. One is by Tankman et al. That included almost 260 eyes. The success rate was 87%. They used this using that scuba technique and using some expensive equipment like colored Teflon block and some Crawlman viewing chamber. Bursa et al. Reported a success rate of 97%, which is quite close to our study. However, the mean age of donor in Bursa et al. Group was almost 20 years higher than us, and that may explain this 4% difference. And one has to remember Dr. Basak is a very expert surgeon in DMEC, so that factor also has to be taken into account. We compared the outcome between the two media, but the number of cases in individual group were too small to arrive at any conclusive evidence. So to conclude, this SAFE technique is a simple, easy to learn, cost-effective technique of DMEC donor preparation that can be used, that can be done using simple keratoplasty instrument without the need of any expensive equipment. However, there are two major limitations. Since this was an experimental study, we could not calculate the endothelial cell density loss. The second was it has to be validated by large clinical studies. I have done 4 cases till now, and with this, these are the poster pictures. I'll conclude. Thank you very much for your kind attention.